Thank you very much. In Uzbekistan, as in many totalitarian countries, human rights activists who defend the rights of people often they find themselves in troubles and need protection. So none of my colleagues honored by ILRF today, ILRF's award, could not come to Washington. Uzbek authorities have done everything possible to prevent them from traveling to foreign countries. The government of Uzbekistan treats human rights activists as hostile and dangerous to the state. So this is the country where we cannot criticize the government, we cannot freely discuss human rights concerns or problems in society. There are no independent media, demonstrations are forbidden, there are no independent NGOs. Often Uzbek-controlled media publish articles in which they write that human rights defenders are traitors, swindlers, crazy, spies of foreign intelligence services, and we usually don't have the opportunity to respond to the slanderous publications in this state-controlled media. But international recognition by foreign colleagues and allies, such as the award presented by the ILRF today, is a strong response to the false accusation of Uzbek government against human rights defenders. So my colleagues, Uzbek human rights activists who risk their lives to expose the suffering and violation of the rights of ordinary people are worthy of such recognition. Therefore, I'm here today to accept this honor on behalf of Yelena, Oktam, and Dmitry. They asked me to convey their greetings, thanks, and appreciations for your support and recognition of their vital and necessary work. Thank you.